Holy Spirit makes us sons and daughters of God. Romans, the 8th chapter, verses 15 through 17. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you received the spirit of adoption, by whom we cry out, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, joint heirs with Christ, if indeed we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together. This week, we spend our time just talking about what the Holy Spirit is to us as believers, who the Holy Spirit is to us as believers, and what he has come to do in our lives. We just want to spend some time reminding ourselves of his presence, his work in our lives. The Holy Spirit is God, as taught and revealed to us in Scripture. He is fully God, just as God the Father, God the Son. The Holy Spirit is not one-third God, but he is fully God. He fully represents the Godhead. He is referred to as the Spirit of the Son, the Spirit of Christ. He is the glory of the Father. And so the Holy Spirit himself represents or fully expresses the Godhead. And he has come to do many things in our lives, and we need to be aware of that. And we need to develop our personal relationship with the Holy Spirit, because he is here dwelling in us as believers. And we need to receive from what he's come to do in our lives. One of the first things that we need to recognize about the work of the Holy Spirit in our lives is that he is the Spirit of sonship. And the Bible tells us that we have received the Spirit of sonship, or the Spirit of adoption, by whom we cry out, Abba, Father. That means the Holy Spirit is the one who has made us sons and daughters of God. He has enabled us to become children of God. He is the Spirit of sonship, the Spirit of adoption. And he bears witness inside of us that we are children of God. That means deep down inside of us, in our very inner being, in our spirit, we have a testimony, we have a conviction, we have a solid assurance inside of us that we are children of God. And that comes from the Holy Spirit himself. Now, many times as believers, or at least in the initial stage, there could be doubts in our minds. There could be questions in our minds about our own relationship with God. Is God my father? Am I his son, or am I his daughter? And all those kinds of doubts which come in our minds. But that's when we must learn to affirm the work of the Holy Spirit in our lives. We must affirm or recognize and acknowledge that the Spirit of God is within us. He is the one who has made us sons and daughters of God. And he is the one who bears witness inside of us that we are children of God. So we declare, or we affirm and say, the Spirit of God dwells in me. The Spirit of God has made me a son or a daughter of God. The Spirit himself bears witness with my spirit that I am a child of God. Galatians 4, 6 through 7 says, because you are sons, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into your hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. The Spirit of his Son is in our hearts, and we cry out, Abba, Father. Affirm that the Holy Spirit has made you a son or a daughter of God. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the indwelling presence of your Holy Spirit. Spirit of God, thank you that you give us that assurance that we are children of God. You are the Spirit of sonship. We thank you for bringing that conviction in our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.